Hey guys, welcome back for another Dokkan Battle video. This weekend, I don't know what time I'm going to actually release this video, but I'm doing a full Great Ape overview this full weekend. So Saturday and Sunday is going to be nothing but Great Ape stuff. So we're going to be talking about today the Great Ape Turles. We're going to also be going over the, well, not just Great Apes, all the Turles stuff. So movie boss category team, Great Ape Turles, physical Goku from the Turles movie. And we're also going to be talking about the JP Great Ape Dokkanings that I have missed. That's the Tora, the Shugesh, and the Borgos. And then we also have to talk about the rare Bardock Dokkanwaking SSR Great Ape. So we have a whole bunch of stuff that we're going to be talking about. We're going to try and fit everything in from Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. But that's a lot of videos to be putting out. So I'll probably have these videos rolling out throughout the entire week from Saturday all the way maybe till Tuesday. But yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into it. Please make sure to hit that subscribe button if you are new and help support the channel. So Decadent Saiyan Turles Great Ape. Now this is the OG SSR card. He is ability, all types, key plus 2, HP attack, or sorry, attack and defense plus 20%, old school ability, supreme damage, rare chance to stun, attack plus 70% when key is 9 or more, which is not that bad, rare chance to turn into a great ape. He's part of low class warrior, giant form, movie bosses, or pure Saiyans categories. It used to be great ape, now it's giant form because of all the transformations of people getting large. 12 key multiplier, 130%, and a rare chance to stun the enemy is 20%, 15% to transform into a great ape. So that's pretty awesome. He Dokkan Awaken with 35 of his own medals, the own Turles medals from the Sinister Destroyer of the Universe event. This is the one that will allow you to Dokkan Awaken your actual movie boss category Turles and the physical Goku. But we're sticking to the Great Ape one. Go over here. You're gonna need 35 of them. You go over to stage two. It's a little bit of a pain in the butt. I brought an AoE Broly. I brought actually a movie boss team pretty much. That way I could AoE the first round, and then the other rounds are pretty much easy. You want to try and kill the technique Turles before he transforms. It takes two turns. If you bring a mono intelligence team, you could definitely do it. But yeah, just go ahead and make sure you do that. I think I actually brought a fusions team until I had enough for my movie boss category team to actually take over. Worked out very, very well for me. Very easier event if you have a good category. Now, he not only Dokkan Awakens, leader ability is all types key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 30%. Still not that great. You can't really take on this event unless you have a really good team. So to say that he is going to have a good leader ability for new players is kind of moot point, because you're not going to be able to get his leader ability unlocked unless you have a team that could take on that category event. And if you do, you're not going to need his leader ability. Super attack is kill driver, supreme damage with medium chance to stun the enemy, which is awesome. Passive skill, key plus 3. Attack plus 90% and a chance to turn into Great Ape up to 2 times when key is 9 or more. So, pretty much means all the time. It means all the freaking time, because he's giving himself 3 key, and chances are you're going to run a double lead where he will always have 6 key total. So you're always going to have that 9 key. Link skills are Destroyer of the Universe, Prepared for Battle, Thirst for Conquest, Big Bad Bosses, Transform, Saiyan Roar, and Fierce Battle. Very nice link skill set. Categories are the same. Max base dupe system are going to be HP of 98-48, attack of 77-27, defense of 45-77. Base dupe system is 11-8, attack is 97-27, defense is 65-77. If you do any type of dupe system, I'd probably just give him full crit, because the Great Ape mechanic now does allow crits and everything. I mean, the stun is there, but it's not, I don't think it's relevant enough for you to focus on giving him any doubles. He already has the free version of the double, so when you go, I would just give the rest of the full crit. 12 key multipliers, 140%, medium chance to stun the enemy is 30%, 15% chance to turn into a Great Ape, and not go up. Passive skill clarification, the key plus 3 and attack plus 90% will only activate when 9 keys 9 or more, while the chance to transform into Great Ape activates at the start of the turn as usual. Okay. So when he transforms, he just has a flat out 4,500 base. Max dupe system is 4,500. Max unlocked dupe system is 1,000. I'm sorry. And fully rainbowed is 50,000 attack. He will get the dupe system buffs as well. In Giant 8 mode, he will no longer take damage and have greatly boosted attack. That's pretty much it. I mean, it's pretty overall simple unit. I just wanted to make sure I went over him with you. Now, in terms of best linking buddies in game, it is going to be all the other Turleses. Let's switch over to the Dokkan Battle Builder view. So we do have all the Turleses up over here. Obviously, the Great Ape Turles, not the Great Ape, obviously the movie boss leader Turles is going to be his best linking buddy in-game overall. Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, Prepare for Battle, Destroyer of the Universe, and Fierce Battle. So many damn link skills. That's 30% between 2, 30, 40, 55% link skills all the time. So that's 55% Link all the time, and then an additional 25% for an 80% attack buff when HP is 80% or below, and 2 ki. Insane, insane combination. The other ones are here. You have the 2 Turtlesses for 4 Link skills apiece, Big Bad Boss, the Thirst for Conquest, Prepare for Battle, and Destroyer of the Universe. No Fierce Battle with him. With the Intelligence one, you get Big Bad Boss's Thirst for Conquest, Prepared for Battle, and Destroyer of the Universe, so no Fierce Battle there either. So both of them are missing Fierce Battle. Everything else is pretty much the same. You do have some really good Link skills there, though. I mean, it's definitely not that bad, especially when they have Destroyer of the Universe together. The other one is going to be Baby Vegeta. They have Big Bad Boss's Thirst for Conquest, Fierce Battle, and Saiyan Roar. So that's definitely not that bad. I think the only one he was missing was Saiyan Roar. So ideally, like, if you were running a rotation, I'm not saying this is what you're going to do, but if you want to see how hard that this Great Ape Turles can run a hit for, you're going to run this for the 80% buff, and then you have an additional over here of another 25% for Saiyan Roar. So that is going to allow him to hit for 105% just from Link skills alone. So that's going to be insane. There's no passives there that are going to really benefit him. Actually, I think the Turles pass may. All allies keep plus 3 attack plus 40%. So you have 105% from the Link skills, and then 40% from the passive skill, which is insane. And then I don't think the baby does anything. He just attacks 100%. Yeah, that's it. So that's a really crazy way to friggin' link everyone together. But yeah, you could do that. Those are his best linking buddies. They are going to come up multiple times in this linking guide. The next one is going to be a mono extreme agility team. Great Ape Turles, well, not Great Ape. The movie boss Turles is one we already talked about. You do have the Great Ape Vegeta for 3 link skills with Big Bad Bosses, Transform, Saiyan Roar. Not that bad, especially on an extreme team. You have Rose, because Prepared for Battle really helps him out there. Fierce Battle, Prepared for Battle, and Big Bad Bosses. And then you have Vegeta. He's on the super side of things, but he is there if you're running just a mono agility team. Prepared for Battle, Fierce Battle, and Saiyan Roar. Saiyan Roar, again, definitely helps out. So that's for a mono agility team. Specifically, these three are going to be for an extreme team. You're really not going to run Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta on the team with him, but you can. They do share those links, like I said. If you have like an LR Majin Vegeta team, it wouldn't hurt if you're lacking good people to link together. The next one is going to be, what did I put this one as? This is the low class warrior. He links with himself. We already talked about all of them, so we're gonna actually just bring them down here. So we already talked about all those Turtlesses. Let's bring the link skills down to 2. And now when you bring it down to 2, it kind of stinks. There's really not a lot for him to link with. You have the Bardock, the 2 Kid Gokus, Raditz, and Fasha. So Bardock, he links with 2 link skills. Transform Saiyan Roar. Goku is Transform Saiyan Roar on both of his. Raditz is Transform Saiyan Roar, and the same thing with Fasha. So honestly, Transform Saiyan Roar, which isn't horrible. I mean, it's a 25% attack buff and 2 ki, which is, you know, there are a lot of units where we'll get 3 link skills, but it's only the same exact thing. So it's definitely not bad running them all together, especially because because of the fact that they all have Saiyan Roar. But outside of that, I mean, I think out of all of these, the Bardock's really the only good one out of the rest of these guys, because the Gokus are really old, like very old. Let's see over here. He is attack plus 80% at the start of the turn, so that's not horrible. That's his Dokkan variant. This Goku's attack and defense plus 70%, really not that great. Attack and defense plus 12% per key orb obtained, unless you have a key orb manipulator, not so much. And actually, Fasha would be that key orb manipulator, so. if you were to run Raditz, you'd probably want Fasha, and if you're going to run Fasha, you'd probably want Raditz, so that way they could help each other out. If anything, there'd be this Goku, but Turles is going to be, or Bardock's going to be the best one you could run. I'm getting them confused. They all look the same. I should not be doing that. But attack plus 100%. Yep. Now we're moving over on to the giant form category, which we already talked about the Vegeta. We already talked about the baby. So the baby is going to be there for 4 link skills with him. I think we already talked about that. Big Bad Boss, Thirst for Conquest, Fierce Battle, and Saiyan Roar. Outside of that, I mean, for giant form, we already went over the Fasha. We already went over the Bardock, the Raditz, the Gokus. So the only two that are left for this is going to be Tapion for 2 link skills with Fierce Battle and Transform, and then the Super Saiyan 3 Goku for Saiyan Roar and Fierce Battle. Not really the most ideal. At least the Goku will give him the passive, so that way he can do additional damage. He doesn't do bad damage at all, by the way. The other one's Tapion, who is just a good tank. So up to you on what you actually want to run with between them. But those are going to be the other guys, other than everyone who I have already mentioned on the Giant Form team. Moving on, this is going to be the movie bosses team. We already talked about, like I said, we've done the Turles. They're pretty much showing up everywhere in this. The only ones that we have left on this is going to be the Frieza first form, the transformation Frieza, and the 2 Koras or coolers, We have the Tech First Form Frieza, who is Big Bad Boss Sisters for Conquest and Fierce Battle. So that's 30% all the time for the attack buff, and then an additional 25%, bringing it up to 55% when HP is is HP's 80% or below, including the defense buff of 25%. For Korra, it's going to be Big Bad Boss Sisters for Conquest and Fierce Battle, same thing, and the same thing for the Tech one. Overall, really nice setup over here. Movie bosses are going to be fun. I mean, obviously, if you have any of these three on the team, you're probably going to want to let them link together because they have better links together. But if you don't and you only have one of them and you're looking for someone else to link alongside of him, one of these guys will probably be a better bet. Again, if you have like Korra and Frieza, look at these two have six link skills together. You're going to want to do that instead. But that's for movie bosses. And last but not least, this is the pure Saiyan. Holler over to the JP side as we do not have this on the global side yet. So the bottom is going to be the Great Apes, as we talked about. Top, we already spoke about the Vegeta. The other two are going to be for pure or for full power. Is going to be the not full power. This is for the pure Saiyan team, the Ultra Goku or the full power Goku for three link skills. Prepared for battle, fierce battle, Saiyan roar. And the same thing over here, prepare for battle, fierce battle, Saiyan roar. Obviously, if you have any two or more of these three up over here, you don't want to link them together on their own team because because they have better link skills. I mean, let's just bring them. No, I don't want you, Godku. There we go. Now let's do that. So if you look over here, Godku, get out of here. And so are you. What the heck are you? They each share six link skills with each other, so if you have any of these three, if you have one or like more than one of these three, just run them together on this team. Do not put it with Turles, there's no reason to, but he does link with them if you don't have anyone else and you want to run Turles because you like Turles for whatever reason. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it. It's a pretty solid card. Overall, I'm pretty sure I rainbowed mine. I'm pretty sure I did. If I didn't rainbow him, I at least gave him nice dupe system. That way I could use him on my teams. He's a very awesome card, and he works out. Again, best linking buddy for the movie boss category lead. I highly recommend getting this card to Super Tech 10 with all four dupes unlocked. I did use Grand Elder Kai's on him in order to do that. He's not farmable at this time. But again, very good. He's going to be a good staple in a lot of teams if you're running the movie boss tier list because you like the movie boss tier list. You're going to want to run those two together all the time. But anyway, guys, that's it for today. Thank you for joining me here today. Again, please make sure to hit that subscribe button to help support the channel. I'll catch you all in the comments below.